Hey guys, I know I said I wasn't gonna make videos on my channel a while ago, but I'm thinking of being an active YouTuber and hopefully get a lot of views. I mean, things I do, I'm gonna start doing a lot of informative stuff on baseball and all that. So right now I'm just gonna, on certain days I'm gonna do different things, but before we get into that, I'm just gonna tell you a couple things about baseball. And so peace, relax, and enjoy the video. Hey guys, what's up? Anyway, I'm just gonna get back into this stuff. This is the most tense game of June 28th, 2012, as Washington Nationals and the Colorado Rockies face. And I gotta say, this is one of the most tense games I've ever seen in my whole life. First inning, Colorado Rockies, believe it or not, 5 runs off the Nationals. When I was looking at this before, I was like, what's going on? And so anyway, first inning, 5 runs. Second inning, 2 runs. So that's 7-0 Colorado Rockies. And the Rockies are not a good team, and the Nationals are leading their division. So just think of this. Third inning, Colorado comes back with 5 other runs. Just think of this. They're pitching, like, whoever was pitching was really messed up. I mean, this is just sad how many points they got off of. So third inning, Washington comes back 5 runs, which is 5-7, Colorado. Fourth inning, Colorado comes back 2 other runs, so that is, so Colorado's still winning, that's 9-5. In the fifth inning, Nationals come back with 4 runs, so that's 9-2, and then fifth inning, Colorado got 1 run, so that is 10-9, 6-7-8 scoreless. And then the ninth inning, Nationals tie the game up into overtime with 1 run. In the 10th inning, this is actually pretty sad, it was scoreless. It went to the 11th inning. Nationals didn't score, but as you can see right here, this is the guy scored. 11-10 Colorado Rockies, which is actually pretty hard to believe. If you look at the stats, they both had 1 error. Colorado got 20 hits off Nationals. Nationals got 14. Like, this is tense. This is tense, and I'll show you a quick video on what actually happens.
Swing and a drive to right center, and the Rockies win it.
And I can't believe that. I was watching the game on MLB TV on my PS3. Use my Xbox. Some of my membership wasn't working, but I don't know, it was a tense game. I mean, anyway, it's a really tense game. Congrats to the Rockies. I'm sort of a national fan. I'm a couple teams. I like a couple teams. I like a lot of teams. Not really because just, I just like it because of players. Some players just, you know, I just really like, and Bryce Harper just couldn't get that ball, and that's a walk-off single. Rockies win 11-10. Anyway, moving on to the next. Anyway, guys, before I lose you, I'm just gonna leave you off one important question that I'm gonna ask the audience watching right now. And if you have a YouTube account, just send your answer in the comments box below. But anyway, what I'm trying to say is, with Matt Kemp's injury and Albert Pujols not doing as good as he should be, and Jose Bautista, as you can see, he's on a hot streak right now. I mean, his team might not be doing good, but he's doing good. And, anyway, speaking of him doing good, I'm just gonna show you a video. I think this was from yesterday, which is June 27th. Proving my point that he is a very good player right now. And, so just enjoy the video and watch.
Bautista high and deep to left, and that should get him a few more votes. Number 25 for Bautista. He has retaken sole possession of the Major League lead in home runs. Lester is up 7-1. He's got a close strike. He's got to make the Blue Jays hit. Hit their way off. I think Jose Bautista knows that. He's putting a couple of those buttons on his shirt and let it go right here. He unloads on this pitch from John Lester. Second will get loose and then see it. That one left the ball coming.
Well, look how Sean say the guy probably was happy that he has Jose Bautista's mark of a ball on his car, but besides that, with Kemp's injury, do you think he would recover like early and still do good, or do you think he would not recover as good as he should be and, you know, not be as good of a player that he was or he used to be before his injury? So what I'm trying to say is, do you think Jose Bautista is going to take his spot? Because Albert Pujols is certainly not doing good right now. I mean, he's doing average, but I expect more than him. I mean, right now, I just looked at his stats. He's on my fantasy team. He has not been getting a lot of points for me, so I was thinking of trading him for, like, Bryce Harper or, like, Jose Bautista. But believe it or not, I would trade him for Bryce Harper, actually. And that might be stupid for some of you, but, you know, I really like that guy. I really like the Nationals, so I'm not really an Angel fan. But anyway, they both rejected my trades, so I didn't get either of them. I stuck with Albert Pujols. But anyway, do you think without Albert Pujols is not going to do, do you think he's going to keep doing bad and not get, and like, increase in his rankings, which is bad because he'll go up from second best to like 15th best? And do you think Matt Kemp's not going to do as good and Jose Bautista is going to take his spot as the best player in MLB right now? Well, that's my prediction for you guys. If you think I'm correct, just tell me in the comments box if you agree with me or not. Anyway, so I hope you liked the video. And I will be making videos almost 2 or 3 times a week, depending on how busy I am. But they're going to be really informative from now on, and see ya. Peace.